Earlier I mentioned there are three regulatory agencies, planning, building, and the fire departments. Before moving to the fire department, let's hear from building and planning officials who have been through the process and have an operating station in their jurisdiction.
Hi, I'm Ron Santos. I'm senior planner with the City of Lake Forest. The city conducted a notice public hearing on the permits for the hydrogen fuel station, and we did not have any public opposition to the project. Planning does not make a distinction between the type of fuel used. We would have processed the proposed facility same as we would any other type of fuel. That's what's different about the project, in that because nobody is familiar with it, that we do treat it different in that respect, because we need the applicant to explain the technology so we can write the staff report and explain it to the Planning Commission. Well, the project developer met with staff early on in the process and also provided literature about the fuel technology. That was very helpful. It was also very helpful that the applicant's team were able to explain the technology and particularly the safety aspects of it at the Planning Commission meeting. I would tell their planners processing a hydrogen fuel station to learn about the technology and be prepared to articulate it to the decision makers.
Because we already permitted compressor natural gas, the hydrogen fuel stations are now, it's a lot easier for us to plan check, process the inspection, and do it right. The role of fire department is more compared to the role of the building department with respect to the hydrogen fuel stations. The proposed hydrogen station was a challenge for us because it was the first time that we saw such a thing in this town, and we were not familiar with it to begin with. But after we reviewed that, we found out it was not really a whole lot different compared to the other station that we checked here. Yes and no. Yes, because it was the first time for us to see such a thing in this city. No, because after we checked it, we found out it's not really a whole lot of difference between hydrogen fuel station compared to the other station that we checked. The building department were not aware for the unique requirement to begin with. But after we got the plans, and we processed the plan check review and inspection, we found out it was a little bit of difference between what we ordinarily check with respect to the stations.
Joe Kirkpatrick, Chief Building Official for the City of Irvine. I would say if a jurisdiction is approached by proponents of a hydrogen fueling station, that they get all of the stakeholders in the room and make sure that there's a clear illustration of the process from start to finish and explore issues that may result in additional steps in the process. For example, in this particular case, the installation will require a planning approval, a planning action that is discretionary and requires processing time, property notification, neighborhood notification, and I think there will be an appeal period as well. So, very important to identify all the processes, understand which ones are linear, which ones can run parallel, and then identify the critical path. There's a standard, it's called NFPA Standard 2, and it covers hydrogen fueling stations. It's the recognized standard. I think everyone on both in the design community and in the review side of things understands that. So it's just a matter of agreeing that a design meets that standard. So when we get our approved plans ready for inspection and construction begins, we will be coordinating with a plan reviewer to ensure that there's clear understanding of what the plans mean. Generally speaking, it's just another installation with a mechanical systems, pipes, electrical supply, power supply, and that sort of thing. So at the basic level, it's nothing we haven't seen before.
As we can see, the requirements for the design, installation, and operation of hydrogen fueling stations are primarily the jurisdiction of local fire and building departments. There is good news for those of us learning about this technology for the first time. Hydrogen fueling station requirements are now very well covered by codes, regulations, and standards, thanks to the practical experience of the early pioneers. Today's regulators and developers have all the tools and guidelines they need to successfully plan a station right now.